The Oklahoma chapter of the Huntington's Disease Society of America is holding its annual Hope Walk this week. They want you to be a part of it. Joining me are Lori and Jimmy Hudson. Appreciate you guys coming in today.
Thank you.
So tell me a little bit about Huntington's disease.
Okay, Huntington's disease is a degenerative brain disease. It's genetically passed on. It affects approximately 30,000 Americans, and with another 200 at risk because of the way it's passed on. It's autosomal dominant, to where if a person has it, they have a 50% chance of passing it on to their children. So it's Huntington's is, it's kind of like, the best way I can describe it is kind of like Alzheimer's, ALS, and Parkinson's all rolled up into one disease that affects a person's ability to think, speak, and even move, ultimately.
And this had a major impact on your family.
Correct, yeah. My father was diagnosed with Huntington's in 2010, and we lost him in 2017.
Wow. So, yes. Just a hard thing to deal with. Mm-hmm. And so you guys are working to help spread the word about this disease and try to get help for those who suffer from it. What are you guys having? What's the story behind the walk? What do you guys do there?
Absolutely, Lauren. So we would like to invite everyone to come join us for this year, the 2018 HDSA Hope Walk. It's going to be at the Route 66 Park, which is kind of on the borderline between UConn and Oklahoma City. It's this Sunday, September 23rd. It's right next to Lake Overholster. So it's at 2 p.m. Registration starts at 1. $25 for the adult and $10 for the children. It's an event for the entire family. It's pet friendly, so bring your fur babies. And we're going to have a lot of fun with prizes and activities. So.
And where does all the money go that you guys raise?
It goes towards not only just research. So as Jimmy was saying, to help the people that have been affected by Huntington's disease and their families, because oftentimes you have more than one person in a family that's affected and symptomatic, so it takes a big toll on those families. So research money, but also it goes towards helping those families find the support they need to kind of get through that struggle. It's a devastating disease, so it doesn't get as much attention as Alzheimer's and Parkinson's because it's not quite as common. So we really need to do all we can to raise as much awareness as we possibly can.
Do you happen to know any of the early symptoms of Huntington's?
Yeah, it's easy to overlook them, especially if it's a later onset. But earlier onset, there's just forgetfulness, things of getting stuck on one repetitive task, the wanting to, almost like obsessive compulsive type behavior that the brain can't shift out of. With my father, the chorea that's associated with Huntington's, it's like some uncontrollable movements, and it's somewhat rhythmic, but the person doesn't even realize they're doing it, and they can't stop doing it. You think that they have like a tic or something, but it's just the way their muscles are making them move.
Man, that's a scary, mm-hmm. scary thing. Well, thank you guys for coming to talk about this, thank and you. Thank you for what you're doing thank to you. Help raise awareness about this. And it's this Saturday, correct?
Sunday.
It's this Sunday. So if you want to come out and help, they're out there this Sunday. It's at Route 66 Park on Northwest 23rd. For more information, go to hdsa.org. Thank you guys again so much for coming out here and for all you guys are doing. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thanks, Lauren.